Good day, my dear students. In this particular period, I would like to make you know how the British became successful over southern part of our country. By the beginning of 18th century, both Portuguese and the Dutch retreated from our Indian subcontinent. They did not completely retreat or go back to their countries, but they tried to limit their trade activities only for few places. Because they came to know that they cannot compete or face the mighty powers of both British and French. Hence, Portuguese and Dutch started to divert their trade activities on Southeast Asian islands, especially the spice-rich islands. Say, they tried to limit their activities over Malaysia, Sumatra, Indonesia, and some other islands. But here in India, say in the middle of 18th century, both French and British, they tried to establish their control over southern India. They tried to have control over the Bombay Presidency or Bombay region. Similarly, over this Madras region and Bengal region. The competition between British and French in establishing their supremacy over this Carnatic region led to three Carnatic wars. The French did not give up their effort or their struggle in establishing their control over this present eastern part of Tamil Nadu. Under the Governor Generalship of Dupley, they tried to establish a firm control over this particular region. Similarly, the British under the governorship of Robert Clive, they also tried to establish their supremacy over this Carnatic region. Both these Europeans knew that unless they have or they establish the control over this region, probably their future efforts in taking over the remaining parts of the country become futile. Hence, French and British, they fought three wars in their way of establishing the control over this Carnatic region or the eastern part of Tamil Nadu or eastern coast of Tamil Nadu. The competition between British and French in establishing their supremacy over the Carnatic region led to the three wars which have been recorded as Carnatic wars. They have been called so because they were fought for the establishment of the supremacy or rule or control over this Carnatic region. There were three wars fought. They have been named as the first Carnatic War, which was fought between 1746 and 48. The second Carnatic War fought between 1749 to 54. And the third Carnatic War fought from 1756, ended in 1763. See, these wars literally gave an opportunity for these European countries or these Europeans to interfere in the internal matters of the Carnatic state or kingdom and Hyderabad kingdom. What had happened? We require to know some kind of developments that had taken place before the beginning of these wars between British and French. These three wars were fought between the British and French in order to meet their interests. In the sense, these wars were fought because of the rivalry existed between the British and the French. And these wars were also the impacts of the British and French rivalry there in Europe. Whatever the developments were taking place between these two countries there in Europe had its impacts or repercussions, influences in India. Because by that time, the war of Austrian succession was going on. Hence, both France and England were the rival countries, as France supported the monarchy, England supported democracy. Hence, the rivalry was existed between France and England. So, as there was enmity between France and England, their Europe, so their rivalry or their enmity was continued in other parts of the world wherever they tried to extend their rule or they tried to establish their control over out of the policies of colonialism and imperialism. Say, the internal matters which were developed or which started to take place in the Carnatic region and Hyderabad region or in Hyderabad state helped both British and French to interfere in the internal matters and utilize the situation in their favor. See, what kind of developments had taken place? See that The kingdom of Hyderabad was established by Asaf Zah in 1724. Asaf Zah had established a kingdom of Hyderabad. The kingdom of Hyderabad was established by Asaf Zah. And there were so many other subordinate rulers who were ruling the nearby areas of the kingdom of Hyderabad. Suppose think that Hyderabad kingdom was extended up to this region, even our northeastern districts, instance, the northeastern districts of Karnataka were the part of Hyderabad kingdom. Say the neighboring some smaller states where the feudatory states or they were the subordinate states to Hyderabad. So there was Nawab of Karnataka region who was a feudatory ruler of Hyderabad state. He was Dostali, Nawab of Karnataka. Was ruling Karnataka state, was a subordinate ruler of Hyderabad kingdom. But he was not loyal to Asaf Zah. Hence, Asaf Zah was trying to remove him from the throne. Meanwhile, the Maratha rulers invaded Karnataka region, this Karnataka region, and they defeated the Karnataka king Dostali and killed him in the battle. Dostali was killed in the battle. Hence, Asaf Zah named Anwaruddin as the Nawab of Karnataka. Anwaruddin became the Nawab of Karnataka. See what had happened. During such circumstances, French and British were watching all such kind of developments. That in a sense, they were watching how the Indian native rulers were quarreling among themselves, how they were invading one another, how they were involving themselves in some mutual squabbles. Say, meanwhile, Dupley, the Governor General of French, asked the assistance of La Bourdonnais, another French chief at Mauritius. In the sense, Dupley, who was quite ambitious in establishing his control over Mauritius, he wanted to utilize this situation and invited La Bourdonnais, his another counterpart or colleague there in Mauritius, to help him. So La Bourdonnais came with his huge army from Mauritius and invaded Karnataka region. Both Dupley and Laudanus. Both Duclay and Laudanus tried to attack Carnatic region, and they were successful to some greater extent. Meanwhile, the British requested Anwar Uddin for their support. So this is what going on between French and British. Say, Duclay, who was there in India as the Governor General of French, requested his counterpart there in Paris, Laudanus, to support him in his effort of establishing his control over Carnatic region. Hence, Laudanus came with his huge army to support him. So, both of them invaded Madras and some other Carnatic regions. So, war took place between British and the French. And British requested Anwar Uddin to support them. Anwar Uddin, the Nawab of Carnatic, sent his army to support the British and to protect his territories. But he was not successful. Anwar Uddin's army failed to defeat the French. As a result of that, see, having sensed the defeat, British tried to woo the friendship of French on other ways. So what did they do? They secretly met Laudanus, who came to help Duclay. And made an agreement with him. They attracted him by giving him huge money. The British attracted Laudanus with an offer of huge money. They tried to corrupt him, they tried to bribe him. So they gave him a lot of money. With that lot of money, Laudanus declared cease of the war. In the sense, he stopped war on the Carnatic region. And he returned the Carnatic region to British. The Nawab of Madras was Anwar Uddin, and some areas were in the British. They were ruling under the guidance of Nizam of Hyderabad as well as Anwar Uddin. Say, they bribed, the British bribed Laudanus, and with lot of money, after handing over or after returning this Carnatic region to Anwar Uddin and British, he went back to Mauritius. Meanwhile, an agreement was made between France and England during Europe, and the war of Austrian succession was about to end by 1747. So, a treaty was made there in Europe, a treaty called Aix-la-Chapelle. A treaty called Aix-la-Chapelle was made between फ्रांस एंड इंग्लैंड दे रही हो, द फर्स्ट कार्बेटिक वॉर वॉज एंडेड. After the end of the first Carbonic War, so the first Carbonic War was ended with the Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle there in 1748. So after the end of first Carbonic War, some kind of developments took place there in Hyderabad and Carnatic states. What kind of developments? Asad Shah, the king of or Nizam of Hyderabad, died in 1748. He died in 1748. After his death, a vessel for throne or war for throne, war for post of Nizam of Hyderabad. War for the throne of Hyderabad broken out between his son Nasir Zain and his daughter's son Muzaffar Zain. In the sense, Asad Shah died in 1748. Asad Shah's death in 1748 made a kind of civil war or war for throne, war for power, broke out between Nasir Zain. Nasir Zain, who was his son, and Muzaffar Zain. Muzaffar Zain, who was his daughter's son, son-in-law, broken out for the throne of Hyderabad. Similarly, a tussle was broken out between Anwaruddin Nawab of Hyderabad. Say, a tussle was broken between Nasir Jain and Muzaffar Jain, therefore the throne of Hyderabad. Similarly, a war started between, war in the sense, a kind of competition, a kind of a civil war, undeclared war, broken out between Anwaruddin and Chanda Sahib. Anwaruddin and Chanda Sahib. Anwaruddin, Nawab of Carnatic, and Chanda Sahib. Between these two, a kind of war started for the post of Nawab of Carnatic. Both Anwaruddin, Chanda Sahib competed to become the Nawab of Carnatic, and Nasir Jain and Muzaffar Jain competed to become the Nizam of Hyderabad. See what had happened. Having seen and observed this kind of situation, political instability or political volatility, then these two carbonatic states. So what did they do? During the second carbonatic war, they tried to British supported Amruti and Nasiji. British supported Nazis to become the Nizam of Hyderabad, and they supported this Anumanti to become the Nawab of Karnataka. And French supported Muzaffar Singh to become the Nizam of Hyderabad and Chanda Sahib to become Chanda Sahib to become the Nawab of Karnataka. So such kind of civil war or war for the throne provided a kind of opportunity for both British and French to interfere in the internal matters of Hyderabad Kingdom and Carnatic Kingdom. British supported Nasir Jung to become the Nizam of Hyderabad. French supported Muzaffar Jung to become the Nizam of Hyderabad. Similarly, over a Carnatic region, Anurudin was supported by British and Chandra Sahib was supported by the French. They made a kind of military alliances. These two groups were formed. What had happened? Say, the French, with the help of Muzaffar Jung and Chanda Sahib, they tried to invade the Carnatic region. They invaded the Carnatic region. The combined forces of French, Muzaffar Jung and Chanda Sahib invaded Carnatic region and they defeated Anuruddin. They defeated Anuruddin. Anuruddin was not only defeated, but he was killed in the battlefield. He was killed in the battlefield. So when Anuruddin was killed in the battle, the French made Salawat Jung as the Nizam of. Of course, Salawat Jung was the son of Asaf Zah. As the Nizam of Hyderabad, Muzaffar Jung was just
So in the changing circumstances, the combined forces of French, Muzaffar Jung and Chanda Sahib invaded the Carnatic region. They defeated Anuruddin in the Ambur battle. In the battle called Ambur, Anuruddin was defeated and he was also killed. See, as a result of that, Chanda Sahib became the Nawab of Carnatic and started to rule as the Nawab of Carnatic, supported by the French. There in Hyderabad, Muzaffar Jung killed Nasir Jung with the support of French and Chanda Sahib. With the support of French and Chanda Sahib, Muzaffar Jung killed Nasir Jung and became Nizam of Hyderabad. But he too was later killed by the rival slave. Muzaffar Jung was also killed by rivals there in Hyderabad. Because of that, the French brought Salabat Jung, another son of Asaf Jung. Salabat Jung. Salabat Jung was made Nizam of Hyderabad. Salabat Jung was made Nizam of Hyderabad by the French. See, when Salabat Jung was made the Nizam of Hyderabad by the French, British did not tolerate this. So they wanted to take the retaliatory action on the French. In the sense, they both had Carnatic, say at Madras. Vellore was the capital city of Carnatic region then. At Vellore, the Nawab was Chanda Sahib, who was supported by the French. And similarly, Muzaffar Jung became the Nizam of Hyderabad Kingdom, who was supported by the French. See, at both the states, the rulers supported by French became the rulers. Hence, the British tried to take retaliatory action, or they tried to suppress such kind of situation. They tried to bring this situation in their favor. So a war was broken out. Robert Clive, who was a very brave and bold and diplomatic. He is a diplomatic strategist. He was a very ambitious. He was quite brave and strong. His ideas in diplomacy as well as in the battlefield were quite imitating one. Hence, he became unbearable in these situations. He invaded, he attacked or caught Arcot. Then Vellore's then name was Arcot. He invaded Vellore or Arcot, the capital of Karnataka region. Say in the war, a war was ensued between the French and British. Robert Clive fought bravely with his huge army, and he too was assisted by some other British army leaders like Sir Eyre Coote and other quite experienced military commanders. Under the leadership of Robert Clive, the British invaded Arcot, and Chanda Sahib and the French army was defeated. Chanda Sahib was killed in the battle. When Chanda Sahib was killed in the battle, in the second Carnatic War, Muhammad Ali, another son of Anwaruddin's son Muhammad Ali, was made as the Nawab of Carnatic by the British. The French, even though they were supported by Muzaffar Jung and Chanda Sahib, being one as Nizam and another as Nawab of both Hyderabad and Carnatic states respectively, they could not face the invasion of Robert Clive. So the French and Chanda Sahib were completely defeated in the Second Carnatic War. And the Second Carnatic War came to an end with the Treaty of Pondicherry. With the Treaty of Pondicherry, in 1754, the Second Carnatic War was ended. And this war brought name and fame for the British. Even though the French were upper hand, for few years they in 1750 to 53, by making Muzaffar Jung and Chanda Sahib as Nizam and Nawab of Hyderabad and Carnatic states, but due to the efforts of Robert Clive, the French upper hand was suppressed, or French influence was reduced. With this defeat, the French started to lose their important places there in South India. And Muhammad Ali started to rule as the Nawab of Carnatic under the guidance of British. See, after this, what had happened? Say, another French military chief, Count de Lally, tried to attack some major places of British in Carnatic after the Second Carnatic War. When Count de Lally tried to attack some major installations or major trade centers of the British. That resulted in the third Carnatic War. The third Carnatic War which was started in 1756 ended in 1763. In this third Carnatic War, Count Italy tried to invade Vandivash. Vandivash is a particular town in Tirumalai district of Tamil Nadu. It is a municipality at present. So he tried to besiege or loot Vandivash. When Count De Lally tried to invade Vandivash, this was not liked by the British. So another British military general, Sir Ironwood, invaded Carnatic region. Sir Ironwood, the British military general, invaded Carnatic region and he imprisoned Bussy, who had supported who was stationed by the French in support of Chanda Sahib there in Carnatic region or there in Carnatic state. While Chanda Sahib became the Nawab, when the French were successful to support Chanda Sahib or to protect Chanda Sahib, Bussy was stationed there with him, or Bussy was nominated to have or to give him protection. So Bussy was defeated by this Sir Ironwood, and Count De Lally, the French general who tried to besiege Vandivash, he too was defeated. He fled to Pondicherry. He ran away without facing the heat of the British invasion. He fled to Pondicherry. There he hid himself. Sir Ironwood even chased him up to Pondicherry. There he was defeated. Count De Lally was captured by the British and later on he was released by them. Say, with this success in the third Carnatic War, the British became unquestionable masters over Carnatic region, especially over this Hyderabad and Carnatic region. The third Carnatic War came to an end with a treaty called Treaty of Paris. Paris is the capital city of France. So whatever the agreement was made between England and France there in Europe had its impacts or its influences there in India. So a Treaty of Paris was made in 1763. Accordingly,
The third permanent war came to an end in India. With this, the British achieved their supremacy there in Carnatic region. And the French lost many of their positions, many of their places. But according to the Treaty of Paris, Pondicherry and Karaikal, these two places were given back to French. And they ruled in future too. In the sense, these places remained with the French even up to the independence of India. So after their success in Carnatic region, the British diverted their attention to establish their control over this rich Bengal region. This Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. So how they became successful in establishing their control over Bengal region? Let us see in another class. Thank you.